Hello everyone, today is my day off, kind of, sort of, so I thought I would make a video today, a crochet video for beginners. So, without further ado, let's just get into it. I don't want to do all that jibber-jabbering, and here I go, I'm starting to do all the jibber-jabbering. Okay, so with crocheting, just the simple act of crocheting, all you need is a needle, size of your choice. I love to crochet with a J or a size 10 or a 6mm is what you would call this. This is like the perfect size to do just about anything. Beanies, scarves, blankets. This is the perfect size for me. I've noticed from some of these other channels, a lot of people like to use the smaller needles. The bigger the needle, the bigger holes you're going to get in your work. As you work, your project gets larger quick. Versus if I have a smaller needle, it's going to take forever just for my project to get to some size and feel like I'm doing something. Okay, so we have our yarn. We have our needle. And of course, with changing colors and things like that, you're going to want some scissors. With sewing in, you're going to want a needle. I don't use needles. I just intertwine my needle. Here I am rambling instead of getting to the point, like I said. Okay, sorry. Anyways, so to begin crochet, what we want to do is create a loop. People have all these other ways of doing it, like we're gonna wrap it around our finger twice, pull one over, pull the needle through, and let it, as you see, I'm not into that, so I didn't even do that right. All I simply do is I cross the yarns around one another, like so. I have a tail here, and then I have the rest of the yarn. I fold my loop over and grab the longest end that has the rest of the yarn, and I just make a loop, and I pull the tail to tighten it. And that's that. I put my needle through, and then I can adjust it. Doing it that way, you can adjust it. Loose, tight. Versus just tying it around your needle. You won't be able to move it. I mean, you can do it if you choose, but you won't be able to move it. I mean, that's just the way it is. I don't know why I'm just I'm a little flustered this morning, but we're going to get through this. All right, so I have my yarn on my needle. And I'm sorry, I don't have all those editorial skills I just didn't choose to have anybody come and film me do this. So you're going to see my work from behind, unfortunately. But I hope you can pick it up. Let me actually come a little bit closer to you. I'm sitting in my car this morning getting some sunshine without actually being out there. I mean, I had to be out there to get in the car, but you know. Okay, anyways. So here we go. We need our loop. So with making any project, unless you do the magic circle, which I don't like, you're going to make a chain. You're going to need a chain. So what we're going to do is I hold the tail, which is the shortest end of my yarn, with my middle finger and my thumb. I hold the rest of the yarn, which is on my bundle. I loop it over my index finger, and that's how I'm able to work. It's kind of like playing a violin. I love the violin, by the way. Anyway, so I'm going to loop it. You loop the yarn. I always have the head of my needle facing me. So I loop the yarn from behind over my needle. I hold the tail with my middle finger and my thumb. The rest of my yarn is drooped over my index finger. And that loop is hooked in my hook. as you can see when I turn it around. It's hooked in my hook. But I'm gonna pull it through that loop I made. Hence why you want that loop a little loose so you can get it through. Okay, and I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna repeat, loop over, pull it through. 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 And this is what it looks like. It looks like a braid. I'm always looking at myself instead of the camera, sorry. It's gonna look like a braid. So, loop over, pull it through. Loop over, pull it through. And I'm just gonna take my middle finger and my thumb back to the top of my project. Loop over, pull it through. 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 I really wish y'all could see the side that I'm looking from. Hold on. Let me see if I can turn around and show you. Ah. Okay. So this is what we doing. Sorry, this is what we doing. So, loop over, pull it through. And this is called a chain. Loop over, pull it through. Loop over, pull it through. Loop over, pull it through. And as you can see, these last few chains I did is looser than the rest. So you kind of got to watch it and feel like what you want, because you don't really want it that loose. You want it to be consistent. Your tension and your needle and yarn to be consistent. Loop over, pull it through. Loop over, pull it through. Loop over, pull it through. This is the beginning of every project, unless you're using the magic circle, which I detest. Anyways, I don't like the magic circle. I just do a chain of four instead of a magic circle. I can't stand a magic circle. Anyways, okay. And again, I can make it loose. I could tighten it up. Just from the way I originally did my loop. All right. I need to let you see it from that other angle, but so we're gonna do it this way first, and then I will turn the camera around and see how it looks. Loop over, pull it through, loop over, pull it through, loop over, pull it through. This is how my hands look. My middle finger and my thumb holding it, holding my project. The rest of my yarn that's on the bundle is drooped over my index finger. And this is how I'm holding it. You can just keep going. Once you get a hang of it, it ain't gonna be no thing. No thing, ain't gonna be no thing. Once you get used to it, it ain't gonna be no thing. So, yeah. Loop over, pull it through. Loop over, pull it through. Loop over, pull it through. Now we're getting some tension. We gotta loosen it up. So you're gonna be working with this all up here and unraveling this. Or you can make a ball. You can put your yarn in a ball. But with that being said, sometimes if you don't have a basket or a bag to put it in, it's gonna be rolling all over the floor. You don't want hair and dirt and lint and all that other stuff in your yarn, because that's gonna be in your project, and that's what you're gonna be giving to someone else, or for yourself. You don't want that. That's germy. Anyways, loop over, pull it through. 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 Loop over. Pull it through. Loop over, and it's going in my hook, remember? Pull it through. And some people actually curve their needle back and forth like that. I don't. I just keep it facing me. Because I don't got time for all of that. Wrist moving. I have carpal tunnel, child. That's painful. So, all right. That's our chain. I'm going to give you a little bit of it. I'm going to do a little bit of it recording me with the camera on the other side. I see how I can do that. I'll try to do that. All right.
Thank you.